What is this and why is it cool? This is thermochromatic paper. Take a look at this. If I place my hand upon this piece of paper, I am transferring some of my body heat onto this piece of paper, and so it changes color. That is neat. But then as the paper takes on the ambient temperature, it turns back into its original color. That's awesome. Why does this work? Well, I'm Jonathan Allers, and this is Destructive Creativity. Let's explore thermochromatic paper and Leuco dyes. Let's take a look. So, Leuco dyes, what are they? Well, they are a chemical that changes its structure very slightly based upon how much heat energy is inside of the structure. So this piece of paper is just a normal piece of paper that has printed on it a bunch of Leuco dyes. And those Leuco dyes allow me to change its color, like I stated before. Just like that. Now we'll get to some more demonstrations later, but I want to talk about what Leuco dyes actually are and where they're used. So, Leuco dyes are the secret formula in these pieces of paper, and they can be swapped back and forth between its Leuco and non-Leuco state, colored and colorless state, as many times as you want until the piece of paper gets destroyed. It doesn't damage the compound to actually swap back and forth between those two states. Why does it change color? When the structure changes that ever so much based on how much energy is inside of it, heat energy, it interacts with light slightly differently, both in how much it absorbs and how much it reflects. And that is the color change that we see. We can do this with pretty much any color. It's really basic and it's really cheap, which means we get to use it for fun. I mean, of course, what else are we going to use it for? We can use it on mugs, so that if you pour hot water inside of a mug, it reveals a secret message. That's using Leuco dyes. What about color-changing clothing, like bathing suits? Yes, there are bathing suits that are printed with Leuco dyes, and they change color when you jump in the water based on the temperature difference of outside to inside the water. There's also color-changing cars, which is so cool. The pigment in the paint is Leuco dyes. It's not just for fun, though. Leuco dyes and thermochromatic paper are used everywhere, from safety labels. A lot of microwavable dishes have safety labels that are made out of Leuco dyes, so that when you put it into the microwave and the liquid gets hot, or the food gets hot inside the container, a warning label will appear saying, warning, hot. It's pretty cool. Have you ever bought anything ever in a store and received a receipt? Well, that receipt is printed on thermochromatic paper, which means that it's a color-changing paper based on how hot it gets. And that also means that if you were to heat up your receipts, it will irretrievably destroy them. So make sure you don't leave them out in the sun. Because Leuco dyes and thermochromatic paper, although it can swap between colored and colorless as many times as you want, if you leave it out in the sun, UV light can irreparably damage Leuco dyes and thermochromatic paper. Also, super extreme temperatures, like right below the point of combustion, it kind of damages them as well, so don't do that. Let's head back to my samples that I got. This is actually a kind of a school sample because it's just a big pack of thermochromatic paper using Leuco dyes. And that allows me to try out some really cool experiments, like putting my handprint on it using my own body temperature. This reacts at approximately 31 degrees Celsius, which means that if it's below 31 degrees Celsius, it will remain its color. But if I raise that temperature a little bit, say using a hairdryer, it will turn into its non-Leuco state, which is clear. That is awesome. Something that's really cool about thermochromatic paper is that once the Leuco dyes are on the piece of paper, you can use it for anything you would a normal piece of paper. So if it can go through a printer, you can print messages on it, or in my case, make an origami crane. So now I have this really cool model that, based on the temperature, changes color. So in this case, I'm using a hairdryer to turn it back into white. That is so cool.